What is a data catalog and why would you need one? Well, to paraphrase Gartner, a data catalog maintains an inventory of data assets and provide context to help users get value from the data they find. So it's what it sounds like. It's an index. It's a catalog of your data assets. If I use an analogy as a consumer, I use Amazon.com to shop online. It provides search, classifies the items I can buy, gives me all the context I need before I put them into my shopping cart. But the Amazon catalog is curated, it's augmented, it's maintained by somebody on the other side of the page. It is also highly governed with complex policies and rules related to availability, price, whether I am a prime customer, and so forth. So in reality, there are three use cases and three audiences of the catalog, and the three of them experience data catalogs in a very different way. Number one, metadata management. The audience is IT. This is the heart of the catalog. It is where the inventory of the data assets is created and where the lifecycle of each asset is maintained. It all starts with connectivity, of course, and the ability to harvest all the metadata from virtually anywhere. The catalog must be able to reconstruct the Google map, if you will, of all the data itineraries. This is what we call data lineage. Some lineage only give you the data provenance, NetSuite. Well, it is sufficient for the end users. For IT, it is crucial for impact analysis that the lineage goes to a more detailed itinerary, giving you every single stop along the way, even the tiniest country road and exactly what kind of processing it went through there. Metadata management also deals with discovering all the data relationships. Physically, like tables in a database, logically, like when a process combines two datasets, or semantically, like when two data assets deal with the same business concept. Recreating these relationships requires inference and automation, ideally with machine learning. I mean, you're not going to stitch everything together manually, that would be too cost ineffective. And finally, you need the management part of metadata management. Configuration management, impact analysis, because this inventory isn't static. Everything changes all the time. New tables are created, new files are ingested, schemas change all the time. That could, well, that will break your data pipelines downstream. Change is good, only if you can manage it well. Number two, data governance. Great, so you have a catalog of all the data assets. You have all the relationships figured out. The lineage hides nothing of the data pipelines, no matter how complex. So now you can unlock this data. Give it to everybody. Create a data-driven culture. Data-driven decisions, here we come. Well, wait. Do we show everything to everyone? When they have access to a piece of data, is there any policy or regulation we must ask them to follow? I live in Europe. We have GDPR. I want to make sure my employees know what to do with the PII. In the US, they have CCPA and HIPAA. Luckily, this is what a governance catalog can help you with. Document the data policies, automatically tag the sensitive data, establish data jurisdictions. It's not all top-down governance either. A catalog must be able to crowdsource the so-called tribal knowledge with comments, scores, reviews, etc. Think Amazon again. Are you sensitive to the other buyers' reviews? I know I am. Beyond that, a lot of the end users of a catalog are subject matter experts. If you could capture some of it, think of the enrichment for your data capital. At the end, a catalog creates a cohesive data culture. Tech folks can be on the same page as business folks. Now, when businesses find it difficult to get a data catalog running, quite frankly, it's typically because the business is not ready to take on a data governance project. I'm not going to lie, governance is a trifecta of tools, processes, and people. Software vendors like us have a big role to play, don't get me wrong, but you have a role too. You must have a data governance strategy. Number three, the externally facing data catalog for end users. What do I mean by end users? People in the analytics and data science teams? Could be a marketing person who needs a bag of data for their next campaign? Or virtually any manager who comes across a report and needs to trust the numbers? Sometimes when people refer to a data catalog, this is only the part they think about. Once again, there's a prerequisite there. The content of the catalog needs to be accurate, up-to-date, very well organized, and all the data assets must carry a ton of context. We spoke about this in the two previous sections, metadata management and governance. No matter how you look at it, you can't have a great catalog without them. The user experience is important too. End users have a real job, so to speak, so they don't spend all their day in the catalog. It's only a mean to an end to them. It's got to be streamlined, simplified for finding data and understanding it. Some catalogs have a consumer-grade type of UI, others have the ability to customize the catalog to only what a user needs and nothing they don't. All right, let's recap all this. A data catalog is an index. Well, it's a catalog of your data. Kind of like Amazon.com, but with your data assets in it. A catalog is only as good as its content, and content changes all the time. So in reality, there are three user profiles. One, internal IT users who need to cope with the metadata management. Two, governance users, such as under the CDO, who are okay for the data to be consumed by everyone, but only if they can govern it. And three, end users, virtually any employee, really, who wants to find data they're looking for, understand it, trust it. This is how a data catalog can maximize data use and value without creating a risk for your organization. Governance is key. You must be able to track where the data has been, who produces it, who consumes it, capture some of the subject matter expertise that is into the brain of the users to share it more broadly. There you go. So let me know if there's something I have overlooked. Do you have a data catalog use case that doesn't fit into these three categories? Do you want to know more about what a governance catalog can do for your organization? Let me know in the comments.